Today I would like to talk about Planet Debug. Planet Debug. When I heard first about it, I thought it was a sort of a satellite cube or something which we can send in space, and then from space we can debug our planet. But apparently this is my wild imagination, and luckily I have Branko Jaksic.
Correct.
Correct, here from MikroElektronika in Belgrado, and he is basically a more expert on what Planet Debug is and what we can what we can do with it. Good morning, Branko. Good to see you.
Good morning. Hello. What's up?
we're talking about Planet Debug, and I have my wild imagination about this, but you can say in much more detail what exactly Planet Debug is, what it is, and what we can do with it. What is Planet Debug, the big picture?
Okay, cool. Thanks for asking me that. So I would say what is unique about the Planet Debug. The Planet Debug is the first of its kind in the world, a remote access IoT lab. You can program and debug any development system remotely. It was created during the COVID era when we were unable to work from the office and had to find a way to access all the necessary hardware without having it physically on our desks. So beyond being a unique solution on its own, it is also unique to us at MikroE as the result of decades of innovation and the creation of time-saving better tools. There are many pieces of the puzzle. For example, the click peripheral boards.
Yeah, I know about them, the click board.
And the C-Brain cards, MCU cards, based on the standard sockets. The development boards, Fusion development boards. And of course, the programmable debugging device over Wi-Fi. Yeah, this is the programmable debugging device over Wi-Fi, the code grip. And of course, the Necto IDE development system.
So these are basically the ingredients you need to have Necto running on. Necto is the SDE. It's a software environment.
Correct.
Allowing you to sit relaxed behind your desk, have a clean desk. You know, there's nothing. You know, there's no hardware. There's no scopes. There's nothing actually. Only your computer, and you go to your server. I assume somewhere in Belgrado. And then from there, you can actually have access to this Planet Debug device. Tell me about this device. What is it? You know, I've seen a picture, but you can tell better.
The Planet Debug basically enables the ability to connect to the required hardware from anywhere in the world. At the same time, a streaming camera the streaming camera provides a live view of what's happening on the board, what's blinking, what's displayed on the screen, etc., etc. Okay. So basically, you have a rack system. In that rack system, you have a lot of development boards, and after that, the streaming camera is going to stream that live stream towards the development board. And after that, you just jump into Necto Studio, open up this exact connection free of charge, and you will be able to program and debug your microcontrollers, your development systems remotely. That's the final thing about it.
Now, if I'm thinking about doing embedded development, you always want to have a very close look on what you're doing. Sometimes there are switches. Sometimes you need to plug in something. Sometimes you want to measure something or get to a specific, want to have a scope and see, is there voltage here or there or whatever it is. How is that working with Planet Debug? Say I want to have, switch something on and off. How does it work?
That's a great question. That is a great question. Yeah,
I'm very good at asking weird questions.
You can basically perform such a thing via SDK, software development kit. Yeah. So we basically have a software development kit available for all of you guys, and you can perform those things just around the in the background. So you can fake the pressing the switch. By using the SDK functions.
Okay, so it's basically a software enabled solution for a typically hardware function
correct.
You're looking at. Yeah.
And okay. There will be another versions of the Planet Debug system rack, which are going to have some physical connectivity as well.
Okay.
So yeah, there will be, but I'm not going to talk about it right now. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Okay. Well, okay. That is only good, because that means that perhaps in the future we will have another opportunity to talk again about the new developments on the Planet Debug.
Oh,
I think, you know, this sounds very nice for students, or for who is this?
Another great question. Okay. the Planet Debug is for everyone. So, but I would say it is particularly valuable for design service companies that outsource their engineers and work remotely. So it eliminates the need to purchase expensive hardware when it can simply be rented and accessed instantly. So no waiting for shipping or additional costs. And as you know, waiting for hardware often takes the most time. But with Planet Debug, that's not the issue.
There's no time. You just log in and you load your Elektor environment, and you can basically run your latest development. Now, I think this is proprietary Micro A hardware, or is it also working with other boards as well? How does it work? What does it allow Elektor to do? You can you choose, say, I want to do something with an Arduino or Raspberry Pi or.
Oh, nice. We basically have, you can actually connect to Arduino boards as well. You can connect to ST, microelectronics boards, microchips, development boards are already on the Planet Debug rack systems.
Okay.
So you can connect to them. So this means that I think that I have answered your question. You can connect to any development board. The required thing is basically the programmer debugger device, which is on our side, the code grip device. With the code grip device, we can actually connect to any development system that you would like to.
Okay. I have another question. You know, if I'm doing development, say, you know, if I'm a student, it's not so big an issue, but if I'm a company, I just want to know that if I do a very specific development and something which, you know, requires some secrecy or some privacy, etc., how is that ensured in your whole environment? Can I just, you know, have a certification that, you know, everything what I'm doing is strictly only for my company? Is it safe to do this, or are you looking at backgrounds? I don't know.
Okay, the entire connection runs through the SSL-secured server, ensuring maximum security. There is no computer running Planet Debug, so there is no risk of data being compromised. But beyond cybersecurity, I would also highlight how environmentally friendly Planet Debug is. It reduces electronic waste, lowers energy consumption, and eliminates the buy, use, dispose cycle. Hardware just ends up collecting dust in the drawer.
So, from a privacy point of view, that means that all my data and all my testing and my whole development basically is stored locally. So
correct.
I have it on my own computer.
Yeah. We do not utilize your source codes. We do not care about that. We just care about the object file, and you are basically sending the object file through the SSL connection. It is just like you're paying something in a grocery store with your credit card.
Yeah. Okay, well, it also means that MikroElektronika, I must say,
yes.
is has a very specific obligation, that is to make sure that you follow the latest and the newest developments on specifically on hardware, new solutions. So how are things organized within MikroElektronika to make sure that we're always working with the latest and the greatest and the newest technology?
Okay, good question. So we have our product lifecycle, of course. So you can definitely tell us, hey, I want this and this development board. So this means that we are going to capture all the information about that development board, pin connections, etc., etc. And after that, we are going to pass all of those that information in our automation task scheduler inside the company. And after that, it is this development board will be supported into our dedicated SDK, open source SDK, mm-hmm. which is an integral part of the Nectar Studio. And after that, we are going to release it. And we can release it just within one day. So once again, supporting the SDK. SDK is an integral part of the Nectar Studio. And we basically have Nectar daily updates. So each day, we have a new support, new development board supported. And you can basically see it. If you install Nectar Studio, you will be able to see that we are instantly each day are installing new development boards as well as
every day.
Yeah, really.
You know, every day you actually making a new board.
You're
updating it. So every time, every morning, coffee. So what new board do we have today?
Okay. Imagine great. That. Yeah, but it is true. You can run Active Studio and you can see it. By yourself.
Okay, excellent. Okay. I let me check my list. I think we had all the questions I had in mind and you covered everything. So I hear you saying, you know, there are some new developments also for Planet Debug coming up. Please notify me and see if we can have another interview to update each other on that. And for now, well, thank you very much. You know, really good to see you and to hear this information.
Thanks again. I will inform you about the Planet Debug features, another new feature. So thanks again.